The Roxanne Torriello Show takes you inside prison and jails as men reveal lives of sin and consequences. Hear God's amazing message of hope. Listen to the testimony of the infamous David Berkowitz and celebrities like Jerome Hines and Melba Moore, to athletes Marvis Frazier and Charles Way, to Dr. D. James Kennedy and Joe Douglas. The Roxanne Torriello Show, where you'll find out how to receive from God forgiveness, a brand new life, and eternal life. Greetings, and I'm Roxanne Torriello. Today, we'll be talking about Bible predictions concerning the end times, predictions about the Antichrist, the mark of the beast, the great tribulation, and the soon return of Jesus Christ. We're going to take a break, and we'll be right back with our guest, Pastor Steve Nash.
The Roxanne Torriello Show takes you inside prison and jails as men reveal lives of sin and consequences. Hear God's amazing message of hope. Listen to the testimony of the infamous David Berkowitz and celebrities like Jerome Hines and Melba Moore, to athletes Marvis Frazier and Charles Way, to Dr. D. James Kennedy and Joe Douglas. The Roxanne Torriello Show, where you'll find out how to receive from God forgiveness, a brand new life, and eternal life.
And welcome back. And joining me today is Pastor Steve Nash. Pastor Nash, thank you so much for allowing us to come here to Hillsboro in your home and have the opportunity to speak to you about the end times.
It's great having you. You're
thank
welcome.
Thank you so much. Now, in the Bible, there are many predictions concerning Israel and the end times. Mm-hmm. Can we first begin by telling us how the nation of Israel came into being.
I have one verse that I wanted to read to you. And it says, God is saying to Abraham, "And I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curses thee, and in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed." And that's why they're called God's chosen people. He chose the Jewish race, starting with Abraham, from all the people of the world.
So they gave us... Through the seed of Abraham came the Messiah, the Savior of the world. They give us the Holy Scriptures through the prophets of old. And through the Messiah, we have all the Savior, Jesus Christ. We have been blessed through him to have forgiveness, to know God and eternal life. So they have been a wonderful, wonderful blessing to the world. Now, God made a special covenant with Abraham, that he would make his name great. He said, "And you, all the families of the earth, will be blessed." That's the seed of Abraham, and through them the Messiah, the Savior, and a promise of land.
Yes.
Now, does the covenant that God made with Abraham and his descendants have incredible implications concerning what's going on in the Middle East today?
Yes.
The land.
It's through the Davidic covenant and the Palestinian covenant where God promised the Jews that they would have so much land or territory. Now, today, that's been restricted greatly. But time has not ended yet, and the Jews will recapture much more land. God's covenants are true and amen. He does not revoke them. He is God. He's in control. No matter what political boundaries may be now, they won't be that way in the future.
Okay. Now, in the New Testament book of Matthew, does the Lord talk about the end times?
Oh, yes. Jesus is saying in verse 5 and following, "For many shall come in my name, saying, I am the Christ, and shall deceive many. And you shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, that you not be troubled. For all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in diverse places. All these things are the beginning of sorrows," or of the birth pangs. A woman beginning to have labor.
Yes.
These are the labor pains of the world. These wars and rumors of wars, false prophets, false Christs, is going to happen, and it's going to intensify as time goes on.
Now, there is an event that Christians call the rapture of the church. Could you explain what this means?
Yes. The word rapture, by the way, is not in the Bible, but the teaching of the rapture is. Rapture means to be taken up, and that's where we get the word. But it says, Psalm 2 is a good psalm out of the Old Testament, but this is the most famous of them all from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4.
Yes.
But I would not have you to be ignorant, brother, concerning them which are asleep or have died, but you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not go ahead of them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord.
Now the rapture. That comes from
1 Thessalonians chapter 4, starting with verse 13.
So there will be people who will never experience death?
Yes.
We know the time of the rapture?
No, we don't for sure. People like to, you know, say yes. that they have a corner on that truth. But I don't think I do. I think that we need to be ready. Some believe that it's going to be before the Great Tribulation. Others teach that it's going to be in the middle of the Great Tribulation, and then still others the end.
Right. We need to be ready.
Be ready.
That's the vital thing. I'd like to ask you, now the Bible speaks about a false Christ. God calls him the Antichrist, the beast, the man of sin. Will this leader rise to world prominence, Pastor Steve?
Yes, he will.
It states this, that this Antichrist, he receives power, a throne, and authority. But from whom?
From Satan himself. Just as Jesus is the incarnation of God, the Antichrist will be the incarnation of Satan.
Revelation, chapter 13, I believe it's 2, states the dragon, as
yes,
you stated.
Yes, or the beast.
Speaking of Satan here, the dragon gave him his power, his throne, and great authority.
Yes.
Another question I'd like to ask you is, will he be a great ruler over many nations? We're
yes.
talking about a world ruler, a world...
One world government.
Leader.
You hear a lot about that already today, don't you? One world
yes.
government, one world order, one world religion. Mm-hmm. All of that's going to take form during the last days.
Now, does the Antichrist put himself above everything and everybody?
Oh, yes. He demands this.
In Daniel 11:36 and 37, it states, he shall exalt and magnify himself above every god, shall speak blasphemies against the God of gods, and he shall regard neither the God of his fathers, nor the desire of women, nor regard any god, for he shall exalt himself above them all. There's another verse too. It states, then he opened his mouth in blasphemy against God, to blaspheme his name, his tabernacle, and those who dwell in heaven. Just as you were stating, that this man is going to exalt himself, magnify himself, as if he were God
yes.
himself. Now, does the Antichrist make a peace treaty with Israel?
Yes, in Daniel chapter 9, I believe mm-hmm. it is, it talks about that, where this peace treaty will be a 7-year, it's called weeks, and halfway through that time period, he will break it with the abomination of desolation of the temple in Jerusalem.
Mm-hmm. Now, what you're saying is that the Bible teaches that the temple will be built again?
Oh, yes. You see, in Ezekiel 38 and 39, it talks about a war with Gog and Magog mm-hmm. and these different countries coming against Israel. That is not Armageddon. That's a war that's going to take place before the very last days. And this man of sin, the Antichrist, is going to come on the scene after mm-hmm. God defeats these enemies of Israel, and he's going to be the peacemaker. He's going to sign that covenant. He's going to be the great charismatic leader that's going to bring sanity, quote, sanity
False
again.
Peace.
False peace.
So
yes.
Now he signs a peace treaty with Israel.
Yes.
The Jewish people begin to sacrifice again?
Yes. That is even in the works this day, where they have, you know, the heifer, the red heifer, and they have plans.
And they're also teaching people the Old Testament Mosaic ceremonial law, the ritual of sacrificing.
Oh, yes, the Hasidic Jews. Yeah, it's thought that maybe an earthquake that's spoken of, again, in Ezekiel 38 and 39, mm-hmm. will take down the Dome of the Rock, and that's the place that the new temple must be built in Jerusalem.
So you're saying that the Antichrist comes on the scene. He has a peace treaty with Israel. The temple is built. The Jewish people begin to sacrifice once again, like in Old Testament times. This man, the Antichrist, he magnifies himself greatly. Will he demand worship?
Oh, yes.
It states this in Revelation chapter 13. And all who dwell on earth will worship him whose names have not been written in the book of life of the Lamb slain from the foundation of the world. What is that telling us?
That means that everyone who has not committed their life to Jesus Christ,
repented and trusted in Christ,
and having their names written in the book of life, will have no other alternative but to worship the Antichrist.
They will worship the Antichrist.
Or be killed.
Or be killed, as some believers,
will
come to repentance and faith during this period of time.
That's right.
Will be killed for their testimony of yeah, Christ.
That's a good point. A lot of people after the rapture will still come to faith in Christ through the Jewish evangelists, it's thought, of Revelation 7 and 14.
144,000.
Yes, they're going to comb the earth and have a great harvest of souls. But those souls will have to pay the ultimate price.
They will die.
They will die, losing their heads.
2 Thessalonians
yes.
chapter 2, 3, and 4 states, let no one deceive you by any means, for that day will not come unless the falling away comes first, and the man of sin is revealed, the son of perdition, son of hell?
Yes.
Who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he sits as God in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. That is amazing. This Antichrist will magnify himself so greatly and then declare himself in the temple to be God?
Yes.
I'd like to read something else, Pastor Steve, and maybe you can explain some of these things to us. It states he was granted power to give breath to the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause as many as would not worship the image of the beast to be killed. He causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on their right hand or on their forehead, end, that no one may buy or sell except one who has the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him who understands calculate the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. His number is 666. Now it talks about worshiping an image. It talks about all of mankind needing to receive a mark on their right hand.
An identification.
Or on their forehead. And that no one could buy or sell. Can you explain some of these things to us a little further?
Well, you know, as time goes on, we guess what this might be. We used to think maybe it's a barcode. Now a chip, maybe under the skin, which would have identification on it and your financial status. If you haven't bought into that system, mm-hmm. you're not going to be able to buy or sell. The cashless society.
You have that already with credit cards.
Yes, that's right. That's right. But even more so then. And it says also in the book of Revelation that a loaf of bread mm-hmm. On the black market mm-hmm. will cost you a day's wage. So the believers are going to have to scurry and do what they can to stay alive because they do not have the mark of the beast.
So those, the things that you're saying are in the realm, the great realm of possibilities, the, what did you say now, the possibility of something being placed
yeah,
in your
chip,
hand, a
chip. In fact, I understand that they do that even today. In immigration processes from India, they've tried it. People that come and go into the United mm-hmm. States often, they've had an experiment where they put a chip under the skin
really?
Of their hand, and they scan it. And then by that chip, they can expedite the customs process of bringing them into the country.
So we see the possibilities of these things. Who knows, maybe in the very near future.
It could happen today.
Right. Let's talk just quickly about some of the things that will be happening during the Great Tribulation. What are some of the things that will take place? I know quickly in Matthew 24, talked, as you stated, about false Christs, earthquakes, wars, killing, nation against nation, pestilences, famines. In the book of Revelation, what are some of the things that that talks about the tremendously horrible times that will be coming upon the earth during this great tribulation period of time?
Well, you have the different judgments of God, the seal judgments, the trumpet judgments.
What might they be, some of the things?
Well, there are many things. For instance, 2/3 of all life will perish, including people.
Two-thirds
of life in the sea, 2/3 of life on land will perish. The sun will become excruciatingly hot, and then a supernova at the very end will take place where it will blow up and the sun will be no more. There's going to be pestilences and people are going to be in agony. They're going to run to the hills and pray that these hills would fall upon them, trying to commit suicide.
The rocks would actually...
Yeah, there's going to be beasts that are going to come out of the earth that look like grasshoppers, and they're going to torment. Yeah, starting with Revelation chapter 6 and going all the way through almost to the end of the book of Revelation, you read of these various judgments of God. And that is only to bring people to their knees to worship Jesus Christ. And you know something? They still don't.
Would not repent.
After all hell has broken loose on earth, everything is perishing. People in their pride and their arrogance will not worship the true God.
Mm-hmm. Hearing all of this, is there hope for Israel and the world?
Unfortunately, the Bible teaches, as I said, that 2/3 of mankind will perish. And if that's true about the nation of Israel, that means it's going to be another Holocaust.
Right.
But of the remnant that remains, Paul says that all of Israel shall be saved.
Will the Messiah come back?
They will look upon him whom they have pierced, and they shall mourn as one mourns for his only son. And some people believe it is going to be the Orthodox Jewish leaders that are alive at that time that are finally going to recognize Jesus as the Messiah, and they are going to turn the people, the remnant, to look upon him by faith whom they have pierced, and therefore they will be saved.
Christ come back, comes back to fight.
Yes, as their captain, as their leader, their commander.
And then we know in the book of Revelation how wonderful heaven will be. Mm. A place of no sin, no sorrow, no death.
Starting with Revelation 21, it goes into 22. It describes a glimpse of heaven.
Yes.
And it's beautiful.
I want to thank you so much again for allowing us to come to your home. It is beautiful. And to have opportunity and insights concerning the end times and the soon return of Jesus Christ.
Even so, come, Lord Jesus.
Thank you so much,
Amen.
Pastor.
Thank you.
What a blessing it is to know you.
Thanks for coming.
And what a blessing to talk to you. You're a wonderful, sweet brother in the Lord.
Praise
thank
the Lord.
You, Pastor
you too.
Steve.
Thank you, Roxanne.
We just heard Bible predictions concerning the end times, predictions about the rise of the Antichrist, the mark of the beast, the great tribulation, and the return of Jesus Christ to rapture the church. And so I ask you, if the Lord were to come today, are you ready to meet him? Or would you be left behind? Or if you were to die before his return, are you ready to meet the Lord? Or would you face judgment and hell? Here's what you must do to be ready if the Lord were to come or if you were to die before his return. The Bible states that we need to repent. We need to acknowledge our sin. The Bible states, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. The Bible states that we need to be willing to turn away from sin, to make a U-turn. We need to believe that Jesus Christ was and is God the Son, who came in human flesh. He came for one main purpose. The Bible states, this is a faithful and true saying, that Jesus Christ came into the world to die, to save sinners. And so we need to believe not only that we are sinners, and that we need to turn from our sin, be willing to turn, but we need to believe that Christ was and is God the Son, and that on Calvary's cross, he died, taking the punishment and the penalty for our sins, being punished instead, in place of you and me. The Bible states, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So we need to believe that on the cross, Christ willingly bore our sins, God taking all of our sins and placing them upon Jesus Christ, and Christ taking in substitution for you and me the penalty and wrath of our sins. The Bible states that he died, he was buried, but on the third day he arose from the dead. So what must you do to be ready to meet the Lord? Again, simply acknowledge that you are a sinner,
Be willing to turn from those sins and place all of your trust in Christ, that He was and is God the Son, and He died personally for you and your sins, was buried and rose again. And upon your repentance and faith in Him and Him alone for God's forgiveness, fellowship, and eternal life, you will receive those gifts and become a child of God. If you would like to receive Christ as your Savior today and have full assurance that you will know Him and spend eternity in heaven, won't you bow your head with me and say these words if you mean them with all of your heart? God, I know that I'm a sinner. I know that I fall short. And God, I want to make a U-turn. I want to turn away from those things that offend you. And Lord, I believe that you came in human flesh and you died on Calvary's cross for me and that you were buried and rose again. I now receive you as the absolute and only way to forgiveness, to having a relationship with you and power to overcome sin and addictions. And I believe that you are the only way to eternal life in heaven. I receive you now as my personal Savior. Thank you, Lord. If you said those words and you meant them with all of your heart, you've become a child of God.
Go to www.roxanneshow.tv. Find out about other cable systems we air on. Then click on TV On Demand. See our shows online 24/7. Also check our cable TV schedule, future guests and times. Learn about our ministries in Africa and in jails and prisons. It's www.roxanneshow.tv.